The near-perfect offensive standard achieved by major leaguers must be maintained on the practice field.
It's time for baseball on a Friday night on the south side of Chicago. Tonight, the first of this three-game weekend series between the Kansas City Royals and the Chicago White Sox. Harper and Goldie slug it out next on the show. Tyler Chatwood will get the starting assignment in this one for the Chi Sox. What's your take on him, H?
Matt, last game he gave up 6 earned runs. So this game, obviously, if he can cut it in half to 3 earned runs, it's going to be an improvement on his performance. So let's see how he executes early in the game.
Stepping up now, Alcides Escobar. Batter-pitcher matchup numbers with Tyler Chatwood. 7 hits in 33 at-bats. 7 strikeouts on the stat sheet as well. Hit on the ground. In time to first, and there are 2 away. Now at the plate, Steve Cook. It's a rough one for him on Wednesday, taking an 0-for-5 in that one. Into the windup and the pitch. Sends that one out of play for strike 1. Harold Reynolds, we look at the Royals as they enter play here tonight. They've been in a nice little groove, winning 3 of their last 4 games.
Well, Matt, that 500 is like the magic number. Now they won their last game. Now they're 1 under 500. If you get the 500, you feel like, okay, now we can start to build something special. But you got to get to that 500 mark. That's why this game is so important. They win today, they're at 500.
Time for a look at the umpires working this one. Behind the plate is Daryl Parker.
Daryl Parker, you know what I see with him, Matt? He's basic. You know, he's a guy that calling balls on the corners is not really his strength. He's going to stay right in the middle. Fundamental Daryl. Here it is. That was a good pitch, good call. I'm going to be safe. That's him.
Swung on and missed. Really fooled him that time for the first out.
All right, here's how the Royals are lined up defensively, brought to you by Majestic. And in the outfield, Bryce Harper. You know, when he first broke into the league, when he was 19, 20 years old, he was running around like a crazy man, all over the place, like a little jackrabbit, out of control. He's calmed it down now, and he's really become a nice outfielder.
Digging in to try it again, Steve Cook. He's 0-for-1 thus far.
Cook.
Here's the first pitch to him. Pitch swung on and hit in the air. After it is Soler. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out. And he will scurry back to first as he'll think twice about it. Ready once
and
again, Steve Cook. He'll
third
start things out here in the bottom of inning number 7.
Cook, have a rip like you can. Here we go now, Hope.
Into the windup and the pitch. Line toward the alley in left center. And this inning starts with a solid base hit.
Well, that's what you want right there. Late in the game, leadoff single. Now, they still got some work to do. You got the tying run on the on-deck circle, but they've got a shot now.
So here is Abisayo Garcia. He started out the evening 0-for-2 so far.
Right fielder, Abisayo Garcia. Hey, your pitch, he's coming to you.
Here comes the pitch for Garcia. Hit toward the right side. In there, a base hit. And that runner will go no further than second as there are 2 aboard now.
Hey, that's a base hit right there. Now they got 2 runners on. This may be their best opportunity to get on the board. They've been shut out the whole game.
Ready for another chance? Brett Laurie. And his guys are looking to erase that donut on the scoreboard with a runner in scoring position.
Yeah, Matt, they've been really shut down so far in this one. They've had runners on base, but haven't been able to string anything together.
Come on, big guy, get your pitch right here.
Here it comes, 0-2. Chopped weakly to the left. He's got it. Escobar. Return throw is in time, and what do you know, they do get the double play.
Hey, they played the matchup there, and it worked out perfectly. Ground ball double play, and that changes the complexion of this inning entirely.
Here's Melky Cabrera. And, Dan, this could be a real make-or-break situation at this point in the game.
Yeah, Matt, at least scoring one run in this inning is so important to them to possibly get back into this thing. Baseball doesn't have a clock, but you only have 27 outs to work with. They're running out of those pretty quick.
No runs, five hits. One error thus far for the White Sox. And a slider swung on and missed, and the side is retired. So they pick up no runs on two hits, no errors, and a runner left on. Eighth inning coming up. It's the Royals 3. Digging in and looking for more, Steve Cook.
Third baseman, Steve Cook.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Curveball, and that misses in the dirt for ball one.
You know, he's one of their guys they rely on to get their offense going. They need a rally, so we'll see if he can spark one here.
He's ready. Here's the 1-0. Ball two. Bases are empty. One man out. Now a pitch swung on and missed. It's 2-1.
Well, they're down a few right here, and I can get all over him for such a big swing. The bases are empty, and he takes a big. But maybe he's trying to light a fire. He catches one and maybe gets him going. Hits the ball in the seats, and now all of a sudden everybody gets rolling.
Come on, big guy.
Into his motion. Here comes the 3. Shot toward second, and a knock for him this time. He's 2-for-4 for the game.
He's got to feel good about himself. A multi-hit game. He knows he's been struggling. We know he's been struggling. Maybe this is the start of good things to come.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, Avisail Garcia. He singled his last time up.
Garcia.
Now a throw over to first, and he'll dive back in.
Your turn right here. Drive him in. Here you go.
Looked like a cut fastball there, and he got him to swing through it for the second out.
Really impressive pitching right there. Sometimes as a pitcher, you can get frustrated when you make a good pitch and you don't get that call from the umpire. But what does he do? He comes back with a good pitch and gets the strike.
Hey, he's right here. Let's go, kid.
This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Huerta has it in his tracks, makes the catch, and that's the ball game.
Yeah, that's what you want to do when you're playing on the road. Take it right to the home squad and get a win. Now the pressure is off. If they get one of the next two, the series is theirs.
Our final line score tonight. First for the
guaranteed right field there on a Saturday night in the Windy City. Tonight, game two of this three-game weekend series between the Kansas City Royals and the Chicago White Sox. It's White Sox baseball, and it comes your way next. Carlos Rodon is on the mound for game two. Harold, what do you got?
Well, what's impressed me looking at his numbers was left-handed hitters are hitting under 200 against him this season. So when he's looking for ways to get out of jams, he's hoping a lefty comes up because the numbers are struggling against him.
Into the box now, Steve Cook. Couple of hits for him in four trips to the plate last night. First pitch on its way. And that one stayed too low, apparently. Harold Reynolds, we look at the Royals as they enter play here tonight. They're on a nice little run, winners of four of their last five ball games.
Well, Matt, we're watching a team that won last game, put them at 500. Now, they're not where they want to be, and there's still several games back in the division, but you just keep pushing one day at a time, and you never know if you might be able to gain some ground.
A 1-1 count. Here's the pitch. Hit the other way out toward right field. Harper has a read on it, and that's the first out of the inning. Time now to check the starting lineup card for the Shy Sox in this one. Who's the one to watch, Dan?
Well, you've really got to be able to appreciate the incredible talent of Paul Goldschmidt. He's really had a heck of a year in the power categories, slugging over 500 coming into this one. That means almost every time he's hitting the ball,
digging in for his second at bat, Steve Cook, 0-for-1 here in the early going.
Let's go, kid. One time right here.
Swung on and missed. It's 0-1. And there are our umpires for this one. Working balls and strikes will be Mr. Daryl Parker.
Now, Matt, Daryl Parker's one of those guys. You're going to take him to dinner. You know what he's going to order? Steak and potatoes. He is basic. He's going to make sure he does not make a mistake. No sushi, no lasagna. He's not going off the board. Steak and potatoes, man, right here, consistent.
One ball, two strikes, count.
Inside, as he might be trying to set him up here, 1-2. 1-2, here it comes. And he had him set up perfectly there as he's not even close to touching that pitch. And on... digging in once again, Steve Cook. No hits in two trips to the plate for him in the ballgame. Swing and a miss. And he's behind 0-1. The 0-1 chop fouled over towards the coaching box.
Hey, see it. Rip it. Here you
into
go.
The windup. Here comes the 0-2. And another foul ball. Now another 0-2. Another one sent foul. Now the pitch. Hit back up the middle.
Attaboy, nice rip.
And no chance there for Escobar. It's a base hit. So with two away, Paul Goldschmidt gets a chance following the base hit.
Well, this cold streak had seen him drop his average below 220, so that's a welcome single, not only from him, but the manager as well.
So it's a runner at first with two gone. And stepping in, the power-hitting first baseman, Paul Goldschmidt.
Goldschmidt.
Goldschmidt. smoked on the ground left side. And that'll just sneak past his outstretched arm, a base hit.
This guy's just a good hitter. You can tell. Anytime you get a base hit on two strikes and you stay with that ball right there, that's why the average is going to stay over 300.
Here's Jonathan Schoop now. These two have not faced each other at the major league level. Five runs, 11 hits, and no errors so far for the White Sox. Chopped weakly to the left. Throw on to first, and the White Sox come up with nothing as the inning is over. So it's no runs on two hits. No. Whit Merrifield next to hit. Previously against Carlos Rodon, one for three.
Get him yourself right here.
He's set. Here's the 2-2. And now a bunt attempt here as he gets this one down. Only play to first, so the sacrifice works that time.
Hey, he tried the surprise attack there with a bunt with a runner on base. Hey, he gets thrown out. But
striding in once again, Steve Cook.
Steve Cook.
Now here's a slider that can't quite get back to the outside corner. It's ball one.
And when you're already down five, the last thing you want to do is fall behind in the count when you're on the mound. That's not going to do anything to help you get back into this thing.
And a fastball just a bit high.
Matt, this is where that guy on first base is distracting the pitcher. I guarantee you, he's down 2-0. He's not focused on the hitter. This is where you get hurt. I love it when a guy on first can run.
But the runner's back easily. Two and oh count and the pitch. Now a ball hit fouled off to the right and up into the crowd. From the belt, kicks and deals. Sent fouled again, and after being way ahead, now it's even at 2-2.
Hey, come on, big dog, get your pitch.
And a fastball swung on and missed as they set him down for the second time here tonight. So it's no runs on a hit. Now at the plate, Steve Cook, leadoff man on base, and we'll see what they have in mind strategy-wise here.
D-Ride!
In the dirt here. And forget about the double play now as he'll move up to second here on the wild pitch. Oh, one pitch on its way. This ball will be chopped foul. Here comes the nothing and two pitch. Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive.
Oh, he might have got away with one. Two-strike breaking ball that ended up being in the zone. I think he probably wanted that out of the zone, but fortunately, he just fouled it off.
And this will be fouled away. Ready with another 0-2. Another foul ball, and this battle will continue.
Yeah, your turn now. No one better. Here you go.
The 0-2 once more. Just staying alive, putting together a really good at-bat here.
This is turning into quite an at-bat. That's five foul balls. He's seeing a lot of pitches.
And no one better. Touch up right here.
Foul back.
That's the sixth ball he's fouled off in a row. You just keep fighting until he gives you something to hit.
Here comes another 0-2. Got him. And that's the third time we've written a K next to his name in this one.
Well, in hindsight, it was the right choice to let the setup guy stay in the game and finish this thing. I wasn't so sure before, but the results sure speak for themselves.
8-4 tonight. The Chicago White Sox. brought the bats in this one with 18 total hits. Carlos Rodon earns win number 7 on the season. Jim Riddle only completed 2. Afternoon baseball set to come your way on a fine afternoon on the south side of Chicago. Today it's the rubber match of this 3-game series between the Kansas City Royals and the Chicago White Sox. These two should provide some big-time fireworks. First pitch is coming up. Jose Quintana, the Colombian native, gets the call to start this one. HR, what's the word on him?
Well, Matt, he's really had a tough time his last 3 outings. ERA over 9. That's basically giving up a run an inning. He just has really struggled and not been able to figure it out. They're giving him the ball, though, and anytime you get the ball, you got a chance to turn it around. We'll see if today's the day he turns it around.
Batting third baseman.
Stepping in, Steve Cook. The average for him entering play, not far north of 200. Now we'll snap one off over to the bag, and the runner back easily.
Come on, guy, get your pitch up there.
And this one's tapped foul at home plate. These Royals, Harold Reynolds, entering play here this afternoon. They come in trying to rebound after a loss that snapped a modest 3-game winning streak.
And, Matt, you always want to win 2 of the 3 games. I mean, today is a big game because you walk away and you start adding up those numbers in the series. You go, we won 2 out of 3 there. That's the goal for every team, to win 2 out of 3 in the series.
And again, he'll snap one over to first. A dive, but he's back.
Hey, any way you can, any way you can. Here we go.
Another one fouled off, and he's quickly behind 0-2. Here it comes, 0-2. Another one sent foul.
Well, that's 3 foul balls in a row. He's definitely battling up there.
Another 0-2 home. There's a swing and a missile sent out to center field. Looking up is Soler. And this one is gone. A home run. Two-run shot to straightaway center. 8th home run on the season for him as the White Sox move ahead 2-1.
Well, he clearly did not miss that one. He got everything behind it, drove it out of the ballpark. I think he was just looking for that pitch and didn't miss it.
Into the box, Ben Castro. He'll step in to lead it off in the top of the 3rd.
Ben Castro.
1-2, here it comes. Left side. Scooped up on the backhand. Throw to first in time, and the leadoff man is gone to start the 3rd. So with one away, let's give you a look at the standings in the American League's Central Division as you see where these 2 teams find themselves entering our ballgame here today. Trying to pick things up where we left off.
Third baseman, number
Steve
13.
Cook.
Steve Cook.
Let's go right here.
First pitch on its way. Fastball, and this one runs in on him as he has to dance out of danger there. He broke out the slide step there, Danny.
Yeah, he's clearly thinking about the steal right here. Didn't happen, but the cat-mouse game continues on.
Come on now.
A 2-1 score here as we play inning number 3.
You can do it. No one better. Let's do it.
2-0 now.
Hey, one thing's clear. He's not afraid to pitch inside, right? One pitch ducks him away, then he comes right back with another one. So clearly this pitcher, he's not afraid to work that inner half of the plate.
And now a called strike that time as the zone expands a bit here. It's 2-1 now.
Love the pitch call there. 2-0. You know the guy's geared up for a fastball, and you drop a changeup in the zone, that's going to be a tough pitch to handle.
Fouled back.
Oh, he's looking pretty good right now. Look, that was a nice swing following the changeup. He just couldn't put it in play.
Let's go right here.
He's set. Here's the 2-2. He got him. And it'll probably take a base hit now to get that runner across from third.
Oh, man, he's been absolutely getting overmatched at the plate the last couple of games. That's his fifth strikeout in this series alone. So clearly this pitching staff, they figured out how to attack.
Steve Cook will stand in here. But before he does, let's take you back to the very first inning. This was a two-run home run right out of the gate that really got these guys off to a fast start. Just a miserable effort there. It's 0-1.
Not much to say about that swing other than it should have never happened.
Come on now, get your pitch up there.
Nothing in one count. Here it comes.
Whoa,
and this misses the outside corner, so it's knotted up at 1-1. Oh, it looked like he was towing an anchor there. 1-2.
Here we go.
Ready on 1-2. And a fastball just a bit up. Here's the pitch on 2-2. And this is going to be a foul ball.
Well, he fouls off that fastball right there, and you wonder, does he love his fastball enough to come back with it three times in a row?
Swing, and he pops him up over toward foul territory. And this is going to wind up a foul ball.
See it, drive it like you can. Here we go.
He's ready with the 2-2 pitch.
Three.
And he takes strike three called on the fastball. One gone. Here's the catcher, Salvador Perez.
The catcher,
it was a two-bagger
13.
For him in his last at-bat.
Salvador Perez.
Into the windup. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. On the ground to third. Throw on to first. Two gone. So digging in now, Steve Cook.
Third baseman, Steve Cook.
Hey, drive those guys in. Here we go.
First pitch coming. Here it is. And here's a ball hit in the air. Moustakas is there for it. And he brings it in for the second out of the inning.
Keys to having a good record in baseball is to win some games at home. So this was a big win to win at home in front of their home crowd.
3-1 the final score this afternoon. Jose Quintana wins his third of the season. David Robertson records the save, his 14th. So that's it for us this afternoon. For Harold Reynolds, Dan Plesac, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vaskirjan. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, log on to theshownation.com.
Line score this afternoon, first for the victorious White Sox. Great job.
Thank you.